Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar. Solve for the area of the circle that is centered at the origin and inscribed between the bell curves with equations y equals e to the power of negative x squared and y equals negative e to the power of negative x squared. Can you figure it out? Give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for the solution. Let's first plot the curves. We have the positive bell curve, y equals e to the power of negative x squared, and then we have the negative bell curve. Before I go over the correct approach, let me explain an invalid method. Because if I don't mention this, someone will invariably leave a comment that they found an easier solution method. This approach will be a necessary condition, but not a sufficient condition. So this approach involves thinking about the geometry. If the circle is just touching the curves, then you could then solve for the circle's radius for the point at which it's tangent to the curves. This could be accomplished by setting the slope of the radius equal to the negative reciprocal of the slope or derivative of the curve. So what I'm going to explain is this is a necessary condition, and one of the values here will coincidentally get to the answer. But this is not a sufficient condition for justifying the answer. Let me explain why. One problem is that you might have the radius of the circle being completely vertical. This is because there's a point on this curve where the slope is zero. So if you were to consider the derivative of this curve, you may be overlooking the point at which the derivative is zero, because the negative reciprocal would have to be an infinite value to consider the case where the radius is vertical. So one mistake is you might potentially be overlooking this solution. But even if you were to manually check for this case, there would be another issue. You would not know whether this circle is wholly contained between these bell curves. And it turns out this particular circle is actually not bound by these bell curves, so it would not be totally inscribed between these curves. Now, if you were to use this incorrect approach, you would actually find another solution which does correspond to the correct answer. But this will be an insufficiently justified answer because you might be overlooking other cases, and you would still have to show why the circle is completely inscribed between the curves. So this is not a valid approach to solving this problem. How can we solve it? Let's think about it geometrically. If the radius of the circle is too small, then it'll be wholly contained between the bell curves, but it won't be touching the curves. At some point, if we expand the radius, the circle will be too large. So we're looking for the point at which the radius is just the right value. At this point, the circle's radius is just large enough to touch the bell curves. Any smaller radius would not touch the bell curves, and any larger radius would not be inscribed between the curves. This point happens when the radius is the minimal distance from the origin to the bell curves. At this minimal value, you can't have any smaller radius, and you also wouldn't want any larger radius, because then you would be touching the bell curves at more points, and it would not be wholly inscribed. So let's use this approach. By symmetry, we can solve for the distance to the positive bell curve with point x, e to the power of negative x squared. So we want to minimize the distance from the origin to the positive bell curve, and we can use the distance formula to get the following expression. But before we continue our calculations, before we take the derivative and solve for when it's equal to zero, there's actually an easier way to solve this problem. Since distance is a non-negative value, we can more easily minimize the distance squared. This will be the distance squared from the origin to the positive bell curve, which ends up being the same function without that messy square root, which will complicate our derivative and further calculations. This is a standard trick whenever we want to minimize the distance. So now let's tackle this problem. We want the minimum value of x squared plus e to the power of negative 2x squared. We'll take the derivative and set it equal to 0 to solve for the critical values. We end up with the following equation, which we can factor out 2x, and now we want to solve for when this equation is equal to 0. So we have two possibilities. One is that 2x will be equal to 0, which means x is equal to 0. In that case, we can check that the distance squared will be 1. Is this the minimal value? Well, let's check if the other solution leads to a smaller distance squared. So we have 1 minus 2 times e to the power of negative 2x squared needs to be equal to 0. We can solve this equation to get x squared is equal to the natural log of square root of 2. If we substitute this back into the distance squared, we end up getting that the distance squared is approximately 0.847, and that's a smaller value than 1. So in fact, this will be the minimal distance squared, and this will be the x value that we want. We want x squared equals the natural log of square root of 2. We reject the solution of x equals 0. So now with this distance squared value, we can then find that the distance squared will be exactly the natural log of the square root of 2 plus 1/2. And notice the distance squared from the origin to the bell curves is also equal to the radius squared, r squared, of the circle, because the distance is equal to the radius. So finally, we want the area of this circle. That'll be pi times r squared, which will equal pi times the distance squared. So we have pi times the quantity natural log of square root of 2 plus 1/2. And that's our answer. Did you figure it out? Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions. If you like this video, you can support me on Patreon. And you can check out my books, which are listed in the video description. You can also catch me on social media, either at Mind Your Decisions or at Presh Talwalkar, depending on the site.